everybody, welcome back. I'm Urvashi and today I'm talking about Jupiter's transit in the nakshatra of Shatpishak till the 2nd of March. So Jupiter is transiting in the sign of Aquarius and it has just a few days ago entered Shatpishak and it is going to be in this nakshatra till the end of Feb, the 2nd of March in fact. This nakshatra is ruled by Rahu. This is a auspicious transit. The nakshatra of Shatpishak, the deity that rules the nakshatra is, you know, Lord Varuna. Varuna Aditya presides over the sign of Cancer. And we know Jupiter is very, very comfortable in the sign of Cancer. In fact, in all the watery Rashis, Jupiter is very comfortable. In Cancer, it gets exalted. And Cancer is for the sign of emotions, home, happiness, comfort. Similarly, this nakshatra of Rahu, Shatpishak, which manifests the most sattvic aspects of Rahu. This nakshatra is also lauded by Varuna and it also is all about healing and comfort, like the sign of Cancer is also about healing and comfort, you know. So this nakshatra is about healing, rejuvenation, you know, it's home that we go back to. There's a lot of similarity if you see between Cancer and the nakshatra of Shatpishak. But of course, there are differences as well. Shatpishak falls in the heart of Aquarius. Aquarius is a very progressive sign. It's all about technology and progress and, you know, everything technical, electronic, electricity, media. So all these lines are bound to progress in this month and a half. You will see a lot of cures. You will see a lot of healing in this time. A lot of rejuvenation will be felt by this very, very auspicious transit. And it is a great opportunity for all of us to rejuvenate ourselves, regenerate ourselves. And Shatpishak is also, one of the symbols for Shatpishak is a circle, which shows being a little confined. It also shows, you know, embracing everything, bringing everything together. And on the other side, it can show some solitary time, some time by yourself where you sit, you introspect, you heal yourself. You rejuvenate yourself. Shatpishak is also about victory, about defeating your enemies. And it all depends on also how these nakshatras, you know, are in your natal chart. But of course, on a general level, is going to be felt by all of us. I'm going to be talking about all the nakshatras as well separately. But to give you a picture, this is a positive transit of Jupiter in Shatpishak. It's about healing, rejuvenation. It's about, you know, just changing things in our lives. It's about getting rid of bad karma. It's about divine grace. You know, Jupiter is very, very happy and comfortable in this nakshatra. And it's all about progress and Jupiter expands everything. There's a lot of expansion that you will see in emotions, in embracing, in going beyond boundaries and barriers of religion and gender and any barriers, and it's all about progress and growth. But this nakshatra is still ruled by Rahu, so, and there is also an element of intoxication attached to this nakshatra. So though it signifies soma, the nectar of healing, but on the lower level, depending on how this transit is going to be for you from your natal Janam Nakshatra or Moon Nakshatra, if this is not a very, very beneficial transit, then you may feel restricted, you may feel more reserved, less communicative, and there can also be themes related to intoxications. This is the Nakshatra of healing as well as the Nakshatra of diseases. So for those, Nakshatras are those lunar mansions for whom this is not a very auspicious transit, be extra careful of, you know, any illnesses that you feel are just starting in this time when Jupiter is transiting, because Jupiter tends to expand everything. So any illnesses that start in the nakshatra of Shatpishak can sometimes take more time and more effort to recover from. But if you are already in a bad health kind of a situation, then this can be a very, very good time for healing, especially if this is an auspicious transit for you. And of course, you also will have to check your dashas and everything else. So generally very, very fortunate transit will help us rejuvenate, will help us find solutions to our issues, will help us, you know, get the comfort that we want, defeat our enemies, defeat any competition that we are in, and bring a lot of positive healing in our lives. Also, if your moon is in Jupiter's signs, if your moon is either in Sagittarius or Pisces, or your moon is in one of Jupiter's nakshatras, so Jupiter, you know, controls the way your mind functions to a large extent. In that case, Jupiter's transit into Shadbishak, into Rahu's nakshatras, can bring a little bit of the Rahu quality on your mind. And especially if you also have a lot of Rahu impact on your natal moon. So this will just enhance that. So this is only for the Jupiter ruled moon signs and Jupiter ruled moon nakshatras. So for those people, you may have a, you know, bigger impact of Rahu right now, that, you know, the feeling of confusion, some amount of illusion, some amount of, you know, too much of breaking of barriers. But all in all, if we think about this nakshatra, it's a sattvic nakshatra. It manifests the positive sattvic qualities of Rahu. So should all actually be on the positive side. This nakshatra is also really, really good for finding things that are lost. So in case there has been situations where you have lost something previously and you're hunting or looking for it, chances of finding that are very bright while Jupiter is transiting in this nakshatra. Are you looking for some hidden knowledge? It's very good for any kind of occult, esoteric sciences, like any kind of healing, Puranic healing, Reiki, and any other forms of occult, as well as all kinds of, you know, technology and electronics, electricity, all those developments you will see during this time. This nakshatra is all about fairness and justice. So these are prominent themes that you will see. Now I'm going to be individually talking about all the nakshatras, and you can see from your Janam Tara where moon is in your natal chart, in which lunar mansion is moon in your natal chart. See from that point how this fares for you. For the Ketu ruled nakshatras, which are Ashwini, Magha and Mula, this is a sadhana nakshatra, a nakshatra of achievement. So Jupiter's transit here is very auspicious for you. It's a time for achievement and success. For Magha, this is like the completion of a cycle. So you will definitely see some kind of completion of work, some kind of achievement, and some kind of things, you know, getting closed, some kind of closures you will find, and some kind of completions you will find. And this also supports marriage for Magha natives. Then for Ashwini natives, this star is your Manastara. So Jupiter's transit here, you can now think of what Jupiter rules in your chart. Those things are going to be very much weighing on your mind, as well as the natural significations of Jupiter, like children for a female, her husband, wealth, prosperity. So these things will somehow be on your mind much more during the next month and a half. Then for the Venus ruled nakshatras, which is Purva Falguni, Purvishada and Bharani, this is a Pratyak Tara for you. Shatbishak is a Pratyak Tara, and Jupiter's transit here is not auspicious. You will find this a challenging time. There will be more challenges and obstacles that will come across, that you will come across. So depending on, again, like I said, where this nakshatra falls from your ascendant, depending on which house Jupiter rules, you know, be very, very aware of what is happening right now. All the negative indications that I shared with you, intoxications, feeling reserved, not feeling very communicative, diseases, you know, those kind of things can be there also. Then I'm going to be talking about the sun ruled nakshatras, which are Uttra Falguni, Uttra Shada and Kritika. So for these three nakshatras, this is a comfortable and happy time. There will be more happiness, more peace, more comfort that you may feel. And for Uttra Shada, there can be some kind of support that you get from your family and home and community. Then the moon ruled nakshatras, which are Hasta, Shravan and Rohini. So for these three nakshatra ruled people, this is not a very, very supportive time. You will find more delays, more problems coming your way, especially Rohini people. Rohini has this problem of, you know, wanting to go on expanding things, just grow, just creating and growing and expanding. So this transit may be some kind of a blockage for you. You may have to stop now, and instead of just focusing on the growth part, you may have to stop and learn to nurture, learn to get things together, learn to consolidate. So these are key themes for you. For Hasta natives, you may have more of professional obstacles and challenges in this month and a half. Then the Mars ruled nakshatras, which are Chitra, Mriga, Shira and Dhanishta. This is a Sampat Tara for you. So this is definitely a fortunate time. This is when, you know, there will be more addition to your values, to what you value in life, even your wealth and family. So this is a positive time for you. Especially for Chitra, this can be a time for professional achievement. So do look at all the transits, do look at your dasha. So this can be a very auspicious time for Chitra. Very supportive. Then the Rahu ruled nakshatras, which are Ardra, Swati, as well as Shatbishak themselves. So this is your Janam Tara. So having any planet in the Janam Tara, you know, especially for Shatbishak natives, they will feel this more. Think of what all Jupiter signifies in your chart, which all houses it rules. And of course, we all know the natural significations, its children, it's, you know, your spouse, especially for a woman, and its prosperity and happiness and joy. So all these things will be more on your mind now. And for Swati people, this can be new learning related to your career. It can be a very positive environment that you get in your career. It can be a very positive attitude on your part. So it's a good time for your career. There can be new beginnings as well for you. Then the Jupiter ruled nakshatras, which are Punarvasu and Vishakha and Purv Bhadrapad. This is the Ati Mitra Tara. And so this is extremely supportive. You know, teachers, gurus, your mentors, fathers, elders, wise, learned people will come and support you. And especially for Purv Bhadrapad, this is very, very supportive. You know, you can get some kind of elevation, some status, some position, some kind of a recognition can be there for you. Then for the Saturn ruled nakshatras, which are Pushya and Anuradha and Uttra Bhadrapad. So for these three, this is a Mitra Tara. It is a favorable, supportive time. You will also have wise, learned people come and support you. This is a auspicious time for you, especially Pushya. So somehow, you know, in your social interactions, if you are interacting with people on large, you know, at a big level, this is going to be a supportive time. And there's going to be a lot of expansion and confidence that you're going to feel in that area. Then I'm going to be talking about the last set of nakshatras, which are ruled by Mercury, which are Ashlesha and Jyeshtha and Revati. For these three nakshatras, this is not a favorable time. There can be sudden endings. There can be sudden ups and downs. Think of all the negative aspects. This is like the 8th house transit, you know, for you people. So 8th house themes, health, and intoxications and other 8th house themes, you know, suddenly something just happens, comes out of the blue and is disturbing. Transformational themes can be there for you. So that is all for now. Check out the links below and keep tuned in. We'll keep seeing you. See you in the next video. Bye-bye for now.